Now, ekdam, you're looking local. You're looking like Karan Kundrra.
Karan Kundrra. Good on you. This meme will
Do you think Dubai is all about tall skyscrapers? Well, today I'm at this historical neighborhood in the Old Seef in Al Fahidi district. Now, we're going to be exploring this place that has a lot of local shop and a traditional vibe going on. But I'm not going to be exploring this all alone. I have a very special guest that's coming all the way from India. He's Indian television's handsome hunk and a favorite reality TV star. Not just that, he's one of my favorite contestants from the Big Boss house as well. We are meeting the charming Karan Kundrra. Oh, hi Karan, how are you?
What's up? How are you?
I'm good.
I am actually very excited. Come back to Dubai after a long time.
When was the first time that she came?
Oh my god, I was decades ago.
Really?
Decades ago, yeah, I'm very old. Yeah, so I think we were kids, we bunked college and we came to Dubai. I know,
oh,
long story.
Wow. Bunked college?
Yes.
Okay.
With hardly any money, and then yeah, it was a surprise for our parents. But yeah, we were brats.
So back then when you came, what was like something that you took back from Dubai that made you want to come back?
The first time I saw this culture. I saw a lot of people coming from a lot of places. And, you know, so it was pretty exciting for me, you know. Dubai is exciting. It's a mixed culture of so many people from so many places around the world.
Yeah.
And getting to meet them, talking to them. For me, it was an experience which sort of evolved me at that time. Because I'm from a small city.
Yeah.
And, you know, so it was pretty cool.
So when you came the last time, did you pick up any slangs of Dubai?
Actually, no. Why don't you teach me?
All right. I mean, I'll teach you the most basic one, which is Habibi.
Habib, okay.
That's yeah, like dear, my love. Yeah. But I mean, you can't just use it like with anyone because it means my love, my dear. So if you go to a random girl like Habibi, she'll get offended.
Yeah, so, I need these warnings.
Yeah, yeah.
Habibi, it's only for one person.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can I use it on my mom?
Oh yeah, of course.
Oh, perfect.
Even with like Tejasvi, of course.
That's given.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, the other one could be Lo Samahti.
Lo Samahti?
Lo Samahti.
Lo Samahti.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Lo Samahti, I think it means like, give us like some time, like some lastamati, like sabar, like thodi der ruk jao.
Okay, okay, yeah.
I think
chill,
so.
Chill.
I'm not sure.
So chill.
Okay.
Lastamati. That's nice.
Okay, Karan. So we are in Old Seef. This is the Al Fahidi. This is the old side of Dubai. As you can see behind and all around us are like some local shops here.
Yes.
Now we have a Kundrra shop as well here, and we're Indians. You're an Indian.
Yes.
And bargaining is sort of in our blood.
It is.
Is it?
It is, yeah.
No?
We're the best, apparently. I'm not. I'm the worst.
Okay.
I'm the worst. You'll see.
All right. So we'll find out. So you have 10 minutes. I'm going to challenge you to get a Kundrra at the best price possible.
The best price possible?
Best price possible.
For them?
For you.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's try this.
All right. So let's start.
In a while. Hello.
Sir.
Hi, how are you doing?
Thanks.
Oh, thank you so much. Size is good?
Perfect.
Okay. This is the first time I'm actually getting this.
So this is basically what Emiratis here wear. This white gown is called Kundrra.
Yeah, I think it looks really nice. All quick colors. Acha pehle main bata ye Saba na, Saba bahut bahut ameer hai. Theek hai, to jo bhi price ab dene wale ho na mereko, aapko usse 2 times or 3 times ye she's generous. She's so generous. Yeah, she's known. No,
family
tickets we don't agree. So we have to like
my follower
be. And I, absolutely. Okay, let's go. Yeah. Dip kar dete hain.
Nahi.
Oh, that's so cool. So you just put perfume on this and just let it be.
Married
nahi hu main.
Now, ekdam, you're looking local. You're looking like Karan Kundrra.
Karan Kundrra.
Good on you.
Yeah, this meme will become. Oh my God, this is the beginning of something that I can see. Sab mujhe ab Karan Kundrra bolne wale. Thanks to Saba.
Socha Karan Kundrra. Abhi mere dimag mein wohi aata hai Karan Kundrra.
You caught me here, no? This is like an inside joke of you guys, right?
No.
I got it. I would have done the same. Good job. Itna bada calculator lane ki zarurat nahi thi. Aise ho jayega hamara. Aise ungliyon mein ho jata hai.
Haan.
So mujhe batao.
Isme zyada better rehta hai.
Isme na ha.
Complete.
Zyada tension hogi.
Zyada attention aayega.
Haan, correct.
Aapko complete.
Turban ke saath ka matlab aise package.
Turban, और
इसमें वो जो
परफ्यूम भी लगा के देंगे आपके
सो तीन चीजें
चार चार परफ्यूम भी लगा के दूंगा
परफ्यूम लगा के परफ्यूम ये तंदूरा
स्कार्फ और वो ब्लैक रिंग जिसको
वो ब्लैक रिंग भी साथ में सॉरी
सो कंप्लीट ड्रेस मैं आपको दूंगा बेस्ट बेस्ट डील मेरी साइड से
हाँ इंडियन रुपीज में ना परफेक्ट परफेक्ट बिल्कुल सही है 1800 दिरहम नहीं बहुत ज्यादा हो रहा है थोड़ा इसको थोड़ा कम करते हैं पैकेज भी ले रहा हूँ ना ये कंदूरा ले रहा हूँ ठीक है परफ्यूम ले रहा हूँ इसको ऐसे ऐसे घुमाऊंगा और मैं पूरे हिंदुस्तान में पैकेज को घूमूंगा यहाँ पे लिखवा देता हूँ आपकी दुकान पे अभी बोलो अभी अब मैं आपको डील देता हूँ
ठीक है
ये 1800 दिरहम था ना 1900
सर हमारा मैजिक इसमें हमारा चलता
है हाँ 19000 रुपए आपको पेमेंट करनी है मेरे को बस
इंडिया में दूंगा
ठीक है डन आपके दिरहम्स भी इंडिया में पहुंच जाएंगे तो बहुत बहुत बहुत
इतना
बड़ा आपका यूट्यूब चैनल है सबा मतलब लोग हिंदुस्तान से दुबई में आए आपके चैनल पे आने के लिए
सिर्फ
देखने के लिए मैं तो आ भी गया खाना खाने के लिए ठीक है तो कितना देना चाहेंगे आप सबा इनको
आपका बार्गेनिंग चैलेंज
मेरा चैलेंज है भाई फ्री 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 माइंड ब्लोइंग इससे बेटर
नहीं सकती फैन हम
हां ब्यूटीफुल आप परफ्यूम की तरफ चलते माय गॉड पूरे इंस्टाग्राम पे करण कुंदूरा वाला थैंक्स टू यू सबा
आई मीन इट्स सो सिमिलर कुंदरा कंदूरा यू नो अब आप जब भी मिले दुबई में What? No, I would never say that.
We've all gone to school. मैं बचपन में मतलब मैं इतना वो हुआ ना इतना बुली हुआ ना ये देखना ये लोग ये मेरे साथ आए हैं ये अपना टर्किश इनको कोई लेना देना नहीं मेरे यहाँ शूट चल रहा है वो अपना मजे में
अपना मजा कर रहे हैं
nice. By the way, my new name is Karan Kundrra, but संभाल लेना back damage control please.
All right, Karan. So हाँ ये मिडिल ईस्ट दुबई की खुशबू है
मैं इस इंटरव्यू के चक्कर में सुबह से मैंने कुछ खाया नहीं है
ओके फाइन हम लोग शुरू करेंगे अपना खाने का जर्नी बट इससे पहले मैं जानना चाहती हूँ आपको कॉफी पसंद है डू यू लाइक कॉफी
आई लव कॉफी आई कांट लिव विदाउट चाय एंड कॉफी
वी विल स्टार्ट विद कॉफी वी हैव अ रियली क्यूट स्टारबक्स देयर सो लेट्स स्टार्ट
क्यूट स्टारबक्स
बहुत क्यूट है
ओके लेट्स डू इट
Ready,
let's go.
Yeah.
This is actually very
good. Yeah.
Thank you for coffee.
Of course.
And main ghar se keh sakta hu ki beautiful girl has got me coffee.
Thank you so much.
Woh bhi Dubai mein.
Dubai ki garmi mein.
I know. I've seen it obviously on social media yeah. and everywhere. But yeah. This is the first time and it's perfect weather for this.
Yeah, and it's also like a lot of people come here because it's like known for the Instagrammable spot and they come here, take loads of pictures and all of yeah. that. So yeah. it's a very pretty
place. Or Kundrra.
yeah, or Kundrra. Yes. So, okay, let's now finally talk about your journey. Where are you from in India?
I am from a city called Jalandhar, okay. which is in Punjab.
All right.
And so my dad's a Punjabi, mom's a Malayali.
Oh.
They met in Mumbai. A long time ago. I have three elder sisters. I was the only one who was born in Punjab. Rest were born in Mumbai. So yeah, I happened to start my journey in 2009. Early 2009. January is when I started as an actor and never gone back.
Where did you start? Like how did your journey into the television industry start?
It's very interesting. Around this time, 2008, okay. November-ish. And Facebook was very, very new. A lot of people are not on there. So I somehow found Ekta Kapoor's Facebook account. There was no Instagram back then. And, you know, so I think that's how it all started. She saw me there. Somebody from her office got in touch with me and they asked me if I wanted to, you know. And I was like, I'm not an actor. And I'm not even in Mumbai. I'm in Punjab. But yeah, why not? And that's how it started.
Wow, yeah. that's so like unlike the usual stories. Like yes. people like have struggled like even applying or getting noticed for that fact.
Yes, but I was not even in Mumbai.
Wow.
I got picked up on Facebook, and this was way back in 2008.
Being on a reality TV must be like, was it scary? Because you know a lot of people are like afraid of showing their true self. Because Absolutely. Being an actor is like playing a role. But,
Absolutely. Yeah. See, doing a show like Big Boss, it's a make it or break it kind of a situation.
Yeah.
Because you cannot pretend. On a show like the format is such that your true self is going to come out right? You can pretend to, you know, be a certain kind of image that you've created over the past years for 10 days, 20 days, 30 days later when you're cut off from the entire universe and these are the only people and then they're making you do tasks, your reality is going to come out. So either people are going to like you or people are going to absolutely hate you, you know, either you're made or you're done, you know, so it is a big risk. It is a fan, it is, it's, you, anybody who's from the industry knows that, you know, you never know what people are going to like about you or you're going to make a mistake. And we're all humans.
Yeah.
We get angry, we get jealous, we get insecure, we are happy, we are, you know, productive. Sometimes you're not.
And Big Boss is probably like one of the biggest reality TVs.
It is the biggest reality TV show in India.
Yeah. And I'm a fan actually. So I obviously watched the season that you were in as well. And obviously rooting for you and Tejasvi till the end. So I want to know, like, even like in terms of you both, like how your story came on television, we all saw as an audience, we all saw that. But how did like it hit when you went back to the reality? How did things evolve?
Well, we used to talk about it a lot. I don't know what's going to happen. Is life going to be outside like? But I guess, you know, so the best part about Big Boss, it's a very stressful situation inside.
Yeah.
Right? It's basically simulation of life, but on steroids. You know, in those 4 months, you're gonna face problems. You're gonna face. They're gonna put you in situations where your compatibility is gonna come out. Your love for each other is gonna come out. You know, it's extreme situation. Yeah. So it was pretty. We were very scared, but I remember saying that the worst is over. You know.
Yeah.
And now it is a much easier life outside, and we faced a lot of things, but I guess the fact that we got close in a situation like Big Boss, then the world is a way easier place.
Oh wow, really?
Because that's a stressful situation. Everybody wanted us to fight, everybody wanted to pull us out, they knew we were strong, they knew ab Karan aur Tejasvi ko alag karoge to hi aapka chance hoga, you know, all of that. If you survive Big Boss, this real world is easy.
Wow.
And you know, whatever a relationship sees in say 4 years, the turmoils and the ups and the downs, we saw it in 4 months. We had our fights, we had everything, but we kept it very real. And when we came out, we realized that whatever we were showing inside to each other was actually who we are. We never hid anything from each other. I was not pretending to be somebody else and she wasn't.
Yeah.
And that's how it is. It's been over a year and 2 months maybe.
I think, that's why the audience also loved your, you know, couple on the show, and the love really shows. And I think that's why even the hashtag #TejRun went so wild.
We had no idea. We had no clue.
Anything you guys do is basically everybody just loves it. All your reels go wild, like 1 million, 2 million, 5 million.
She
just goes up.
Some reel which is like, what, we've got 30?
Yeah, 30 lakh, million.
Yeah, likes and some 30 million views or something. That's just grateful.
But do you think also like there's like pro and con to having your love life out in the open, like public?
I guess there are. I don't know about the pros. I mean, I'm pretty vocal about, you know, my relationships. And this is the first time I think Tejasvi is also very, you know, out there. And that's where the trust comes in. So personally, I really don't care.
Okay.
I don't care. I've been always out and about with, and you know, if you've seen me from the time that we've come out, I've been pretty vocal and so has Tejasvi. And this is the first time for her to be, you know, accepting. A lot of people love it. In fact, you know, I was just hearing I saw a video of Sunny Leone, and she was like, dude, these guys are cool, they're pretty real, they're out there, not hiding anything. And I also think that those days are gone, and I don't want to follow somebody and everything.
Yeah.
But yeah, there are cons, people who are probably can't digest the fact, they will always come up with something.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, they're not paying our bills. And so I'm okay, I'm pretty, you get a lot of hate sometimes. But see, again, this is something that Tejasvi said, you know, I was getting a lot of hate. And then she said that there are millions of people who are loving you. And if you're ignoring them and you're looking at a few haters who are actually, you can count them on your fingers, then that's not fair to all the people who are loving you.
So yeah.
That day I changed my focus. Like, she's right. You know?
True.
So anywhere, there's always going to be somebody who's sitting somewhere jiska liver sad raha hai tumhe dekh ke, and can't do anything about that. That's just human nature.
Because I know, like, when we watch the show, there's so many different opinions. Like, there's so many different people. Like, hamare ghar mein, like me, my mom, we are like rooting for you guys. But then we see that, they're showing people. Anyways, are you hungry now? Are you hungry? Okay, now I know you. No, we're going to have some very delicious local food now that we've explored the Fahidi historical district. Now we're going to head for some delicious food.
So let's go. I am so ready for this. Let's eat.
All right, Karan, we are at the Arabian Teahouse. This is one of local favorite restaurants. It's definitely like a hidden gem here at the Fahidi district.
It is.
What do you think?
It is completely different from the outside world.
Yeah. It literally opens you to a new place.
It is beautiful and it smells really nice. And a lot of people, this is a very popular place.
Yeah, it's a local favorite for sure.
My kind of place.
Hello.
My pleasure.
Majboos lamb.
Lahm. Lahm.
Lahm.
Lahm.
Lahm. Lahm.
So let me just like sort of tell you what it is. Do you know what this is?
Yes. What is it?
This is called Harees.
Harees, yes.
Harissa, yeah. Harissa. So it's just made of like meat and it's very like healthy, and a lot of people especially have it like during Ramadan.
Yes.
During iftar time, this because very nutritional.
Correct.
So, and this is Majboos is So lahm means meat.
Yes.
So it's basically just meat and rice.
Meat and rice.
Yeah. Looks and yeah. So do you want to get started?
Yeah, and what is this?
This is just samosa.
It has like samosa?
Huh.
Oh, okay. मेरे को लगा कुछ ऐसी यहाँ की exotic side dish होगी.
Something with chicken, like chicken curry.
Rice.
Yeah, rice and then you have your salad. Yeah. Oh, okay, sorry. Thank you. Oh, yeah, it's a little gooey.
Moment of truth.
Please taste test.
Yes. Oh. Yeah, it's heavy.
Yeah. Usually when people come to Dubai, they look at the tall skyscrapers, you know, fancy bling bling. But this is like the old Dubai and they're like
I'm
such
so
hidden
glad
gems.
You got me here.
Yeah.
This is so my kind of place.
Oh, I'm so glad then. So what kind of food do you usually eat?
When I'm working, mostly Indian food.
Okay.
Yeah. I can actually live on Arabic food because it's very nutritious.
Yeah.
And you know, because we work out a lot and everything, I can survive.
When you're traveling, do you miss home food? Cheers.
Always, always.
What's your favorite home food?
As I said, mums are Malayali.
Yeah.
South Indian food is a part of our daily diet. You know, married to a Punjabi, lived in Punjab for such a long time, so I've got the best of both the worlds.
Wow.
Yeah. And also, my mom really loves cooking. Like she makes butter chicken without butter.
Oh wow!
And it's actually healthy.
And it tastes good, the same.
Wow! Trust me.
Amazing.
Trust me.
What's your favorite South Indian food?
I live on idli sambar.
Idli sambar.
Every day morning, it's the perfect. It's got the right amount of carbs. It's got the right amount of protein, and you know, you get the strength to you know take it throughout the day. She makes the most amazing fish.
Yeah.
She makes the most amazing rajma chawal. I'm telling you, my mom's like,
the list goes on.
Yeah, life sorted.
All right. I want to play a fun rapid fire test, yeah?
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Alu ke parathe or sushi?
What do you think my answer is?
Alu ke parathe. Okay. Your go-to comfort food is?
Has to be either idli sambar or dal chawal. Dal chawal sorts everything out. Rajma chawal, all dals and chawal.
One show that you did you're most proud of?
I think Kundrra.
Kundrra.
Okay. Was a show about teenagers and crime, and you know, it was an entire generation where we literally forced people to talk to their kids, you know, because there was a gap between parents and their kids, and kids were not telling their parents what was wrong with them, and the parents weren't asking, and so many people were like, oh, we just realized that the communication barrier is creating problems. It's not the same generation anymore. They're not our kids are not like us.
A vegetable you just can't eat.
I don't know, Loki? Who wants to have Loki?
A dish you can cook any time of the week.
The simplest and the most amazing thing that I can cook is dal chawal.
Okay,
yeah. I can also make spinach chicken.
Oh.
Palak paneer banate na, palak ki jagah paneer ki jagah main chicken.
Chicken. Nice. Fine dining or eating at a dhaba?
Dhaba.
Oh, okay.
Or any time. Okay. I can take a flight, go eat at a dhaba and come back.
Okay. Your favorite co-star or contestant?
My favorite contestant is Tejasvi Prakash Weingankar.
Alright. Was becoming an actor always your dream?
Never. I didn't even think about it. It just happened to me. Destiny.
So like as a child, what was your like first go-to like, oh, main ye banunga?
No, I was definitely, because my dad was a businessman. I was always brought up you know, to be independent and you have to do your own business and then, you know, help dad and, you know, so MBA was the go-to thing. And I was already running a call center by the time I became an actor. So I was always like, I was just reading all these autobiographies of all these business people, Steve Jobs and all that.
Your favorite memory from Big Boss?
So many of them.
Big Boss is an experience
which has completely changed the way I look at myself.
Oh, okay.
You know, because you spend a lot of time with yourself. You understand what you like, what you dislike, what kind of people you're born with. And it's just pure. There's no adulteration. There's no people from outside coming and telling you, oh, you should do this or you should be with this person because of this.
It's pure
your perception.
Yeah.
So you come out more aware of yourself.
So I have one final question that I think, again, I'm something very curious to know. And I'm sure I'm speaking for most people who even watch reality TV shows. Everybody wonders if Big Boss is scripted.
What do you mean by
it? Yani, they tell you what to do or how to act.
So the from the day I entered till the day I got out of that area, which is about this much.
Okay.
Apart from the people who used to come in as guests and Salman Khan.
Yeah.
I did not see a human being. Sometimes you would see a reflection or something somewhere. We could see one tree and monkeys and birds. If I'm watching somebody 24/7 being maker of the show, because I've also done reality shows where I'm behind, I'm on the other side of the camera.
Yeah.
I know that if this guy likes this girl and he's going to react if I put this girl in a task with somebody he doesn't like, I know I will create a situation for him to react. I'm not going to go and tell him, listen, you have to react like this.
That's bullshit.
Doesn't work like that.
Makes sense.
So we guys know, because there are cameras on you all the time. Nothing, not even a small reaction is missed.
Yeah.
They are noting down everything. Guys sitting there, oh, Karan saw Tejasvi and he was like, oh, Karan and Umar, they're very good friends. Oh, right. Okay. So let's see if Umar is going to react like this in a situation like this. That's what they do. That's what we do when we are behind camera.
Yeah.
We know.
So Karan, lastly, I want to know, are there any more movies that you're going to indulge in? Are you looking forward?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Absolutely. So I have two films that are ready.
Oh.
So 2023 should be the release.
Okay.
And we are in talks with certain other films that... Stories. The right kind of stories.
Okay.
I don't want to do run-of-the-mill stuff. I really want to plan every move. Because I don't want to live the way I'm living. I want to have a more relaxed, calculated life.
Planned life.
Yeah, planned life.
Yeah.
When it comes to career. So accordingly, I will now take my decisions. And I want to be part of now. See, I've made what I wanted to make.
Yeah.
I'm not scared anymore. Now I don't want my my problems to dictate what I should do.
Yeah.
So I want to create that space for myself.
I mean, we're very excited to see your future movies and, you know, we're all looking forward to that. Thank you so much for being on the show.
It was absolutely my pleasure.
To see you around in Dubai more often.
Yes, yeah? Eating.
Eating together also.
Yes.
Thank
or
you
shopping.
So much. Both, Kundrra.
She had to end it on this. She had to.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.